Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. Tonight, we find ourselves in the seas of Nova Scotia. I've been harvesting tuna, haven't found any swordfish for a while, but I also haven't been line fishing in a while. Just been running this boat. I did unlock all, at least as far as I can tell, all of the additional boats that are in the game. They're all boats from Barents Sea, so they're not anything new. The new boats are found already in the harbors, but I think this is going to be closer up here. But unfortunately, I did that backwards. Oh, dang it. Come on, pull it in. Let's go. They're turning. I think I would catch one that quick, but come on. Come here, you fish. So anyway, I have found a couple things since I saw you last. One, I don't know that now that I know how to do this, I don't know that buying the Borga was such a great idea. I have upgraded this boat all the way. Man, there's so much we need to go over. First of all, this clock, you can actually click on the clock and sleep while you're on the boat, which is amazing. That is such a huge advancement over the last one, because we were asking for that and they actually did give it to us. Secondly, the autopilot, there we go. I want to turn that engine off. The autopilot engages when you're in the map. It does not work when you're like here clicking the button. You have to be in the map for it to work. Anything else I wanted to tell you? yeah, I would not have. I've done so well with this. The way that you trigger the fish to start to be in the sea is you have to, when you first start the game, go into the town and look for swordfish tips, and you'll get a tip from town for the swordfish, and that'll get you your first round of swordfish going. Seems like once you find that first round of swordfish, you're going to get a bunch of new fish spawning in the ocean all the time. But before that, it's really hard to find them. So now I was able to spawn them by putting down fishing lines, and then it kind of spawned the fish in the ocean, and then you started getting these fish. But it seems like for it to work properly, you have to kind of go to the town first to get that guy to tell you a little tip about where these swordfish are. Now, one of the things that also that have changed, what was I telling you? Hang on a second. Yeah, it's a little too loud. These fish totally changed pattern on me. So anyway, you get those swordfish going, you'll start to make a lot of money. And so I upgraded the ship all the way. Things that I wanted to share with you, definitely not worth the while. Don't bother with the upgraded binoculars. You might want to get one upgrade, like one level up, but to be honest with you, they don't really help that much. And you see the fish with or without them as far out as you're going to see them. The fish, see that one is out way there, right here. That fish right there, that's about as far as you see them out anyway. So you can see them without the binoculars. After trying different stuff out, I just realized that the upgrade binoculars don't really help, unfortunately. You can see a lot further. I've got them right now. I'll show them to you before we go in. So you can see things more clearly once you're already close to them, but it doesn't help you see things any further out, which kind of, that was disappointing to me. And they're expensive. Like I think I spent $8,000 or $10,000. The other thing that doesn't help at all is the searchlight upgrade. I thought maybe I'd get a wider, bigger pattern. It's exactly the same between searchlights. I've got the most expensive one on here, and the pattern and distance and brightness are all the same. It doesn't really make a difference, so it's all for looks. So don't bother upgrading the searchlights either. That was a big disappointment for me. I thought it would have like a wider swath, and that it doesn't do that. So don't bother with the binoculars, and don't bother with the searchlight. I think as far as tips, that's all I really have at this point. I'm going to finish filling up this boat. Stop it. My wife is trying to distract me. And
I'm trying to walk.
Yeah. So anyway, I know they're coming around this way, though. They keep changing pattern on me here.
She's pretty.
Missed. Ugh. Wish I could surf off the, or shoot off the back of the boat. So let's see if we can get him. Yeah, we're going to have to move again. Anyway, so I'm going to finish this load up, and then I will go into harbor, and we will try deep line fishing tonight. So that's going to be our goal, is to do some... Oh, wait, no. Oh, cut. Where did those fish come from? Come on, get out there. No. Oh, I'm going to miss them. Oh. All right, so we just stay right here. All right, guys, I'll be back. I'm going to catch these fish, and then we'll be in. Screwed that up. I didn't realize they'd come back right next to me like that. But this is a good spot to be in then, I guess. All right, so we are headed back into port. Once again, I haven't figured out, and if somebody knows, please throw it my way, the information. Difficulty figuring out how to see pricing on each port. Like, what? I wish I could see, like, Wiki Finance? Fish prices. Here we go. Okay, so right now, tuna's $5 a kilogram in Yarmouth. What? That's not possible. $5 a kilogram? So here's one of the things about this game. The more you deliver to a certain port, the less they become more valuable. So there's still $25 in Lundberg. Lockport is $36. I'm trying to see because we have a pretty full load of tuna. $5 Ingalls Head, so don't go there. Digby, $6.78. Dennis Point, $8.64. So once again, I went into logbook. I went into finances, and I went to fish prices. So we're going to go, let's see, 36. So we're going to go towards Lockport and sell our tuna there. So you need to know, on the map here, I've marked locations. I will try to remember what boats are at each of these locations. I found all the ships. I think I found them all. I went all over the map, and I think I found all the hidden ships. They're all ships from Fishing Barents Sea. This one for sure was the my favorite one, the Vibiki. It runs about $800,000 for the Vibiki. So right here in this isthmus near Ingalls. This was, I believe, let me think. This one was the Moby Dick, I believe. So we'll get that out of there. And that is, if you look again, that is, here's Cape Fort Chew, and that's right by our Yarmouth. So down here, you have to kind of work your way through the channels. There's like a buoyed off area, and you work your way up here. So once again, that's right here on the map. Moby Dick. I believe this was it's the small one. This was the Snarset, I believe. This is one of those smaller fishing boats. I don't remember which one. Sorry, I can't remember the name. It's the yellow one. But it's a line and net boat. Up here, we had... Gosh, I can't remember. I don't remember. But these are... Anyway, so this isthmus here, there's a boat. Look for this kind of weird thing. And here's one here. I'm pretty sure that this last one up here was the Lunar... Yeah, I'm positive on this one. This was the Lunar Bow right here. So that's where that was. So you can have all the ships that you can get, and that was the last one in this area. So once again, go back, review the video, and see what I just put. But we need to go to Lockport. So there's Dennis. There's Lockport, right? That was the best pay. Ledger fish prices. 36. And then we're going to look at our map. And I think we can fast travel there. So we'll go ahead and... So here's where the autopilot comes in, and I'm still a little bit not completely sure on its usage, but you can set the speed that you want to travel instead of going the full speed. I don't. Who cares? That's what I'm saying. Like, I don't understand. I don't know. Why don't you? Wouldn't you want to go at top speed? Like, or do you want to actually go slower? I don't know. Because you can't really go out. You have to wait till it goes all the way there anyway, and then return. So I don't get why you would do through here. I'm gonna look up and kind of see why they did that. There has to be some reason why they have you set the autopilot, but it doesn't work when you're in the boat. It only works when you're out of the boat. And I heard somebody was saying, like, oh yeah, it's a really useful feature, and I haven't figured out why that is yet. So anyway, but let's go ahead and sell this tuna. We should actually make some seriously good money off this tuna. And once again, it's not a full load. I got room for maybe like three or four more big tuna on the ship, but I wanted to get this taken care of because I'd like to do some deep line fishing tonight for this episode, because I haven't done that yet. And we'll go out and try that out for this boat. And this boat's making good money. So if you're having a hard time finding the fish on the surface, once again, you could do what I did and, you know, take some of that $30,000 you start with and buy your, what was the name of the boat? The Borga, the barge. Or you could, you know, just keep trying, or switch over to deep line fishing. Take that money and set the boat up for deep line fishing. But I'm up to almost $220,000, and that's after upgrading all this stuff. So I've made maybe $300,000-$350,000 with this boat pretty quickly. Like, this is only the third day that I've owned the game, and we're already making a ton of money with this boat. So now the deep line fishing, the deep line hooks have a sensor on them that tell you when you caught a fish, but it doesn't, it just goes by time. Unfortunately, they didn't make it realistic where it'll text you, it sends you a text message in your wiki telling you when you've caught a fish. Well, that's really cool, except for they're just at 18 hours or 18 and a half hours is when the sensor goes off. So the first one you laid will go off, then the second one you laid will go off, then the third one you laid will go off. You never actually get to maybe the third one has a sensor but nothing else does. Now we got some wiki messages, so let's go ahead and see what we got here. How do I do that? I can never find the logbook. It's map. Yeah. Here we go. We have a journal message. Autumn. Oh, autumn has begun already? What? Summer just began. How do we get to autumn already? What? Okay, well. And these are just messages showing us what we caught. I hate the way that I wish you could turn some of these off. Yeah, we caught a tuna, right? And so the port's in here. This is Lockport. I think this is the dock right here, but maybe not. Let's see. Nope, it's back here. Once again, this is just one of those fun, relaxing, kind of kickback simulator games. I really like it. I know people are asking when it comes to console. I don't know. I'm imagining that they probably are going to bring it to console, because they did with the other one. They may, however, be waiting till the new consoles come out. So I don't know for a fact when they're coming out. I haven't heard anything from them saying when they would come out. But all right, so let's get in here and... I guess there's a bug, too. You have to watch, and we'll see if they fix this or not. If you're out to sea with a crew member and you save your game and you don't put them back at the dock and port, you'll actually lose that crew member. Now, I'm going to try that out with this one, but it sucks because you lose big money when that happens, because they're, you know, crew members are $40,000, $50,000 for good ones. But hopefully that won't be the case. I'm trying to slow it down a little bit. 6 knots in the harbor area. Look at all those nice tuna stacked up on the back. So the tuna are worth it. Before I was kind of like they're not worth it, but if you can go to the correct port and see how much they're paying, and you get one that's a high paying port, it's definitely worth it. So we'll stop here and we'll take a look at some of the ships that are available out of Lockport, and then we'll go deep line fishing. All right, so we're gonna cut the engine, and we're gonna go ahead and dock. And yeah, look at that revenue. Holy cow, look at that. And this is not even a full load. I could have gotten $200,000 if I would have filled the ship up all the way. Look at that. So pretty quickly here, we're getting into the range of being able to buy a bigger boat if we wanted to, but I'm happy with this one for right now. So fish prices are still good. Tunas probably come down a little bit. 43 for swordfish. Tuna still 36, so yep. Town. Let's take a look here. Actually, we'll go to the dock first. We'll see the boats. Stars of the show available. We have here Sharky. That's the one. Sharky is the little yellow boat, so this one is a 35-foot boat length. Holds 8 long line, 1,000 hook long lines, or 8 nets. You can have 2 crew members, so you can have guys help you do the net fishing with this boat. That's pretty nice. And it's a pretty low price, actually, $115,000. We could sell Borga and pick up this boat and do some heavier line fishing with it. But we're not there yet. This is the kind of fishing you do in the winter because the season ends for some of this stuff. So Snarset is, we're in range of getting the Snarset. And honestly, I probably, instead of getting the Sharky, I might get Snarset. Eventually, I'll own all the boats, but Snarset's not that expensive at $550,000. Holds 4 crew members, and this is a full-on ship. This one will have a freezer. It has machine gutters. It has the ability to palletize the fish. You can do both long line, 10,000 hook long line, and nets. So this boat, fully upgraded, probably is going to be more like double that price. Think about $1 million. But it's worth it because you're going to make a ton of money. Probably $2.5 million every time you bring a load in, I think. Well, we'll see how this game's economy is. It might be different. But we have the Nova Scotia, which is another one that I found. Obviously, this is the Earl C, which is our grab boat. Yep. You guys will remember this from the other... Svalbard, that's what it was called. I was trying to remember what the name was. It's called the Svalbard. But here it's called Nova Scotia. And then we have the Ocean Runner, which is a long line and net and crabbing boat. So here's another good boat, $695. Not too expensive, but you know, we can try all these boats out. Nova Scotia is snow crab. This is lobster. So does this one do lobster? No. Okay. So if I want to do a lobster boat, we might go with one of these and try lobstering with this. We'll see what the different boats are for the lobster boats. But that is another lobster boat that's fairly affordable, decent crew size. Looks cool. But tonight, we're not going to go there. We're going to run this ship for a couple more rounds, make some more money. So we're going to go into town, and I'm going to look for some... Let's see. We'll hop in the bar. Let's see what tips we have. Pollock from 3 days ago. Nah, swordfish 3 days ago. Let's get it. Okay, that's been marked on the map. And tuna from a week ago is free. You might as well get that too. But the swordfish are where the big money's at. So let's go ahead and look at crew members. I do want to hire a crew member. And let's see who we got. We're looking for somebody that's good at deep line fishing is what we're looking for. He's a crew 7. 5. They get better as they go, so you're not stuck with these numbers. As they get practice, they get better. 10. Ooh. He's expensive. 6. Graham is an 8. 34. He's not too bad. 5 and 3. So, was it this guy? Michael's pretty, or Mikhail. Mikhail Wood. He seems like he's pretty well balanced, so let's go ahead and grab this dude. And Pearl. Arg. Oh, I'm not gonna do that voice because I'll get hit. Alright, so how many, I think that's the only crew member we could take. So we're going to save our game here, because just in case the poop hits the fan. So F, what is it? Save career. Put that there. All right. But you can see easily, once we start making these fish catches, even with the tuna, go to the right port and you make some money. Dock up, and we're going to go to fish market again. And, oh, the dock. We need to change our ship over to the, and I've already purchased it, the rigging for DEEPLINE. We're going to equip that, okay? And then we need to go to the fish market, and we're going to fish gear. And we're going to grab DEEPLINEs. And we can fit how many on this boat? I think 8. Yep, so 8. There we go. And we're going to buy the DEEPLINEs, so we're going to still bait the DEEPLINEs. So we have 2 to 5. All right, so we have either herring, which catches more sword or more tuna, or squid.
Squidward.
Which does swordfish. We really want swordfish, so bait with squid. Bait with squid. I want squid. I don't want herring. I want squid. What? Squid DEEPLINE. Oh, we have to pick each one separately. Okay. Squid. Yep. Squid. Bearing in mind, I've never done this. I've watched my wife do it. I've never done it myself, so. Squid. Squid. Squad. And Squidward. And all his cousins. Squid DEEPLINEs. Okay, good. And let's get back out into the ocean. And we're going to look at the map real quick and see where our tuna hint was here. So we're going to go south and a bit west. So let's go ahead and do that. Slowly turn. Oh, you know what we forgot to do before we leave? We need maintenance. Glad I saw that as we were leaving. Okay. All right, let's try this again. So long, Lockaport. And where do we go out? Once again, the speed in these areas is lower than you want it to be, for sure. 5-6 knots, I think, is the limit. So gotta keep it slow and low. Though I wonder, okay, let's get out of port here. I'm gonna see something here. Okay, so if we do this, I have a theory. I'm gonna put down these flags, right? Nope. And we're going to take this down south like that. And where's our tuna helper? Right there. Okay, so we're going to go here. And then, hold on. Okay, so I've mapped this out and put my speed in. So I want to see if this will do it. Oh, it does. Look, it's starting to run the boat. So you put the autopilot speed in and you map your course, and the boat will try to follow it. This is a little frightening because I'm going way too fast. Set it for 6 knots. It's not responding to that change. God. Oh, Lordy. Full speed. 15.5. So that's it. 15.5 is the speed. And so now the boat will just run by itself. That's kind of cool. So you don't have to, like, go into the map and fast travel. Once again, fast traveling takes up 50% more gas. I did verify that, and it actually is the case. So you don't necessarily want to fast travel, because it's going to take up a lot more fuel. And fuel, of course, is, you know, $200 or $300 to fill up half a tank. So if you want to save money, you will just take a ride and go along with it. So, but there goes a look at turn for us. The autopilot's running. So you set the autopilot up in the map, and then you power it on. And that's how you do it. And then you put the initial speed in on the map. Now, one thing that we do need to do, zoom this out a little bit. But now my guy can just rest and enjoy the ride. That's pretty neat. And it is really dark out there. What is this? These are the... No, keep that off. Here's where you tell the crew member what to do. We're not going to tell them to do anything yet. I'm not sure exactly how that works. It's been a while, and this game's a little different, but he's resting right now, so we'll let him rest. Let's take a look at our... That's it. Yeah, we sold some fish. Thanks. I wish you could read the logbook while the boat was moving. That way you could save some time. But I'm going to go ahead and get out there. So I'll be right back. All right, so we have arrived at the location. And we're going to go ahead and switch this over to sonar. And we're going to start moving forward. A couple knots. This is the hint location. Now, it was from a couple days ago, or 3 days ago, I think, which... we need to also... Do I have the best sonar? Oh, no. I might not have gotten the best sonar. Oh, I think I forgot. I left that out because I was surface fishing. Oh, I'm such a dork. Oh, well. Now, this is where the deeper scanning sonar would come in handy, because we're deep line fishing. So I'm a doofball for not doing that. In fact, I almost might go back to port. I'm thinking we need to turn around and try again, because I really don't want to put those down and not actually see where the tuna and stuff are. What is on there now? Let's see on this one. This is a little more clear. You got... Yeah. Boy, that was dumb. Okay, I'll be back, folks. I'm going to come back to this location, but I need to stink and run back to port first. That really stinks. We need to see deeper. We're back in Lockport, and let's see, we are going to go to our dock upgrades. Yeah, we're spending some money. Now, one of the things I like about this game is that you can go right to the best equipment. You don't have to, in the old version of the game, you had to buy every single piece of equipment to get to the best equipment. Here, you can just skip right past it, and boom. So we're going to go ahead and, I'm going to jump back. So I'll catch you guys out at sea. And we'll do the same thing again, this time with the right sonar. Whoops. All right, so I've used up a bit of fuel. We're still above half a tank, though, so we'll be fine. I am looking 500 meters. Right now we have, looks like a couple tuna and a lot of other fish. Well, water's 96 meters deep here. I think the sonar here, with this newer sonar, it automatically scales. Too fast here. How fast are we traveling? Slow it down a bit. But we're heading right towards that map marker where he showed us. In fact, we're right above it. And I don't see any tuna. There's one. Tuna behind us, probably about 2 minutes. So there is tuna in this area. Or not tuna, I'm sorry, swordfish. There's swordfish in this area, but not many from what I'm seeing. And we'll poke out a little bit further south. See what we see. I'm also visually looking around for tuna. I don't see anything on the surface. There's something over there. What is that? Nope. No tuna. No tuna on the radar. Something out there. So once again, you might want to go with the 4X binoculars. I don't think you really need to, like, I'm not zoomed in all the way. They're kind of, at 10X, they're kind of impractical. You can see everything at, like, 2 to 4X, so. There's the tuna right there. We just swam past. Any more swordfish? Nope. Tuna. Another tuna. And more tuna. Well, we're getting a lot of money for tuna too, so I'm not gonna poo-poo tuna, but we really want to see some swordfish action going on, and I'm not seeing anything right here. This was a bad tip. So we'll swing this way. Let's kind of float around here and see what we can find. Just tons of tuna. But that's good. Tuna, like I said, tuna's gonna bring us money. There are a lot of fish here though, so that's good. I don't see any flotillas of swordfish, though. More tuna underneath us. We're surrounded by tuna. I want to do something here. We're going to jump upstairs and see what we can see. We'll get those binocs out. I'm not seeing anything aside from tuna. Tuna, more tuna. Well, tuna it might be, so let's go ahead and kill the engine here. It's going to be the X key. And we're going to go ahead and get our crew member out here to get the work done. Let's give him a call. I'm going to have them prepare gear. And we're going to go ahead and putter ahead at a slow speed of about, probably do 4 or 5 knots. I might as well just start setting these things and see what we catch. Now, there are people, I was watching some guys that set, like, literally tons. Yes, there's no tuna. There's a couple tuna in there. They went by a minute or two ago, so we'll set in this area. Hopefully we'll catch some tuna. I mean, not tuna, swordfish. Gosh, I keep getting them. Yes. My wife just called me Joe Biden. If it helps you feel any better, my wife likes Joe Biden, so. Alright, so is he prepping one? I think he should be prepping. Okay, so he did. Yep, he prepped it. And we need to wait till we get further away from this gear, and we're just going to run in a nice straight line. Maybe we want to run a little faster. 5 knots, maybe. Second gear. Now there's some tuna down at the bottom there. Hopefully we'll catch that guy. Swordfish. There's some deep tuna fish, Norda. Sudtordness. Yeah. There's a tuna right underneath us. Drop that bad boy. There's a swordfish way down at the bottom. So we'll get a nice mixture of fish. Sometimes that means you have to go to two ports to get the most for your money. Why are you grunting? I don't know. Seems a little odd. She's grunting, folks. Excuse me. Alright, so he's prepping still. Any more? Let's see, I can't. There was another tuna we just passed over, so good. I think we're going to catch some good, decent tuna. Look at all the fish out here. I'm sneezing. A bunch of tuna we just passed over. More tuna. All right, and more swordfish. Tuna, 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 swordfish, swordfish, swordfish. Yeah, tuna. Whatever fish. Bonk fish. I forget fish. There's number 7, and we got one more to set. Now, once again, I've never done this mini game before, so my wife was really good at it. I'm hoping I'll be able to do okay at it. She caught a bunch of fish. So, honey, I'll have to show you how to find the ports, the best prices on the ports, because there's a way to see them all. You already know? Why didn't you tell me? And there's another tuna, or another swordfish, or whatever. Another fish thingy. What, babe? All right. So we've set our long lines, and we're going to let them sit for a little bit. I'm going to call my crew member and send them back to house. You can rest now, Michael. Mikhail Gorbachev. I wish there was a way you could bring extra bait with you, but that way you could just keep putting lines out, but that's not going to happen. So I see lots of swordfish and lots of tuna as we're passing back this way. That's good. We'll catch some fish. We're going to go back to the front of our lines here and park the boat for the night. We need to also look at our settings here for our lights. We don't need all these lights on. Turn the search light off. Don't need the work lights. Look at tuna. Look out, tuna. We're going to swing around here at the end of this guy and all right, so we're going to cut the engine right here and we're going to drop anchor, which I don't think does anything, but it's there, it's pressable. Okay, so we're going to leave this here, shut the engine off, and we're just going to float. And so I'm going to go ahead and set the clock. First, I need to look at our hours. Does it show us on here? Can I tell? No. So we need to look at, we need to go out here and see our hook status. The first status has been out for 46 minutes. So we're going to wait. Let's see. 18 hours. We're going to wait 18 hours. Boom. And these are going to come in, and they're going to show blue on our map. This one just turned blue. And I bet you we have a deep line bite. Oh, look at this. 2 minutes ago. A minute ago. And so it's exactly like 18 hours and 45 minutes is so, yeah, these are all set. Yep. So, yeah, it's really kind of silly that way, but go ahead and start the boat up and we're going to go ahead and turn our lights on. Nope, that's, here we go. And our crew member, we're going to go ahead and do a deep line haul. We're going to back up just a little bit and then come back around again. We're going to sneak over this way a little bit and pick these up. Come on, get home. 75 minutes, 3 hours later. All right, we're going to get the butt turned around this way so it's, and it goes straight back. Haul that deep line. Okay. So we have to hit that target right on the head. He got one. Perfect. So we caught a tuna. That looks like a dolphin. Ooh. Caught a tuna. Okay, there we go. So we got two tunas off that haul. You laughing at me? No, one tuna. Weren't there two tunas on there? Does he catch them or no? Babs, does he catch them or no? Because it doesn't look like he did. I'm a little ticked off with the guy right now. I spent a lot of money and he missed a fish. It's like... $20,000 down the drain, Mr. Fish Guy. This is why you'd want to set more hooks, though, because my ship has huge capacity. All right, let's haul these deep lines. Oh, no fish were caught. Oh, I didn't wait. Oh, shoot. You gotta wait till they turn blue. Dang it. That sucks. And you do lose the bait when you do that, so that really stinks. We're gonna have a crappy haul. Let's do this then. Let's make things better. Oh, 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 oh. Come on. Oh, you're not, you can't do both. I forgot. Okay, well. The next one's ready, so. Carry on, men. This is going to suck. We're still going to make good money, but not like what I was hoping we'd make. So I feel like if that's the way it is, you're almost better off. If you're only catching one fish, you're going to have a total of like 7 fish. You might be better off just doing the old harpoon fishing, because I catch a ton of fish. Harpooning, you actually catch more fish. It's a longer process, though, and you have to find the fish. This way, the fish just come to you, but we're not getting a very good catch here. You usually get 2 fish per hook, maybe even 3. I've seen Moni get 3 before, and we're pulling up 1s and 2s, or nuns, because we pulled them too early. So... So don't haul them till they turn blue. Lesson learned. All right, Michael, Mikhail, whatever. It's a waiting game. I might advance time 1 hour. Because then they're all done. Let's see. It's probably a really bad idea, but let's try it. All right, so. Oh, wait. Okay, these are going out of order. Weird. So I've ruined two of them. But that's okay. It's a learning process. This is the first time I've ever done it. There's mistakes to be made. Well, look. The only two of them, only one of them came back. Dang it. We're only going to catch like four fish. Oh, and I forgot this guy. He's got to. Do we still have crew tiredness? Yeah, he's getting tired. So we'll let him rest for a bit. What, honey? Well, apparently so. I'm doing crap right now. I would almost want to set, like, have two sets of deep lines. You can only buy one set, really. I wasn't paying attention and I got skunked. Alright. Alright, pull this one, dude. Tuna, please. Yeah, one fish. Good. Wasn't perfect. Wait, where did my tuna go? Oh, another one just went right. Right? No? Nope. So we'll go ahead and jump time another hour. Nothing yet. Okay, another hour. Seems dodgy. These aren't catching anything. So we just not a good spot, maybe? I don't. It looks so good. Like, I can't imagine that this is that bad, but. What does this say? It's still good. Okay, well. Let's take our crew member and let him rest for a bit. And, well, that's cool. So maybe they. There was a big, you know what, there was a patch today. I wonder if they changed that. Because yours all went in order, didn't they, Babs? They went in a different order? Okay, it's been 1 hour. 2 hours? This can't be right. There's no bites, though. It says one day. So you really could set multiples out here, I guess, and just leave them. Well, let's keep pushing hours ahead and see what happens. But it's not great for our. At some point, I think they'll just disappear, won't they? Oh, yeah. Wow. So this has not proved profitable for me at all. Did you get hooks on catches on every single hook that you put down? I've been out for, let's see, what does this say? No, they're still good, though. They're starting to turn red, but for one day. 6 hours? Seems awfully long. Let's see our catch. We need to see our fish freshness, which I don't know. Let's see. Here we go. Catch time. 11 hours, we're still good there. So I guess we just keep waiting. What? That can't be right. Very frustrating. Yeah, they're just, I'm not going to, they're, the lines are showing that they're halfway used. What does this mean, that red? So I wonder if next time I'm going to try something different. Let's see. Let's take a look at our catch and see how it's doing. Huh. Well, I think we're just going to pull them in because at this point I don't want to let the fish that I have caught go bad. So we're just going to pull these in and they'll come up as duds. But we'll sell the fish that we have, so. That kind of stinks. I'm not real happy with that, but that's my fault, sort of. Not really. Anyway, so I'm finding that I'm having better luck with the spearfishing than with the deep line fishing. But I also have seen people online do it and be very successful, so I don't know. Yep. This is saying deep line's ineffective, shallow water. So maybe they just need to
put him in too shallow water.
I guess so. But this is where they said the swordfish were. Oh, but that might not actually work for us because, yeah. So we screwed up. We put the deep lines in the wrong spot, and that. Yeah. Yep, well, there you go. Yeah. Shut up. Okay, so I completely ruined that. It's okay, we'll make some money on this trip anyway, but bummer. What a dud. Caught two lousy fish. All right, we'll try it again. What, honey? We'll try in deep water this time. Yeah, so I'll come back. I'm going to get set up, guys. We're almost at an hour for this video. I try to keep my videos an hour or under. So I'm going to go ahead and take a break here for a little bit on recording, and I will catch up to you when I have these deep lines set in better water. We're going to move. What I think we're going to do is move out into this area here and see what we see on the sonar. I'll catch up with you when we do that. So see you guys in a little bit. $32,000 for three fish. That's not bad. We're back up to where we were anyway. Let's get out there and get some actual fish caught this time. Oh my gosh. I'll be back. All right, the scenario's been set. Crew member, take your place. And we're going to start collecting these. You'll notice I waited till about 18 hours. I could have probably started a little earlier. Seven of the eight lines have caught fish, so that's good news. It was positioning. Now, I went into very deep water, and waited till I saw some tuna and a bunch of other fish and some swordfish, and seems to have paid off because we now have a lot of fish on the line. I still don't think you're reusing your boat to capacity unless you want, because I upgraded to 6,000 kilograms. I'm almost doubling the capacity of what we can haul, I think. I don't know that, though. We got two of these. Let's see if we can get this guy here. Got that one. Wow, that's a big swordfish. Imagine pulling that up on the deck. It'd be pretty intimidating in real life. Yeah, got a good. Didn't get it perfect. All right. Moving right along. Two swordfish. That's the way to go. Smaller ones. 389. That's not a very good catch. when you spearfish them, they bring in about 300 kilograms a piece. So we're 150 to 200 kilograms short on that. It's not very good. Oh, and our final one popped, so we're good. But it seems like right about the 18-hour mark is when they start to pop. All right. One, it looks like we just have one in this line, so. Good. Were you getting perfects on all yours, honey, or good also? Because you are perfect. Oh, no, but there, no, we went to 600, 562. That's about 250-pounder. That's not too bad. Ta-da. Oh, I should have waited. Okay. Only one fish on that line. 731. Still, it's going to be good money. Just not as good as I would have liked. And to be honest with you, not a ton of effort. It's probably easier doing this than it is to do the spearfishing. The only downside, once again, the spearfishing really lets you pull the or push the boat to capacity. Man. Oh. Dang. $900. But we're still going to make, let's see, that four fish. I mean, I'm going to say we're going to make $50,000-$60,000. Maybe more. Why is it so bouncy? Were yours like this, Babs? How am I supposed to hit that? I don't know. I can't. Dang. Could be because we're way out at sea. Like, we're in pretty deep ocean. Like, did you go all the way to the bottom of the map?
Yeah.
Oh. The waves are being weird. No, look at the waves. Look how weird they are. Like, they're really bouncy. That's buggy. Those aren't realistic waves. That's not fair. It's like the ocean is... Oh. It's like the ocean has turned to jelly. Okay, well, good. I don't feel so bad then, because yours wasn't that... This is like... Not-so-choppy. Ugh. I can't, the boat, it's so choppy, I can't even back the boat up. Alright. That's a little better. See? If the waves are like that, I can do it. Man. And see how much more weight we gained there? We gained almost 400 kilograms because I got a perfect. So the perfect is, it's really important to get perfect if you can. But that the game was being a little weird there. That wasn't really fair. Wasn't fair. But we're definitely not going to get the $200,000 I was hoping for. So you, once again, if you can find swordfish naturally, when I say naturally, I mean with the harpoon gun and on the surface when they're in a flotilla hunting, you probably are going to do a lot better. Now, if we bait for tuna, we might end up, you know, pulling in more fish, like two instead of one, and that would fill up our capacity. but... So if you're going to do deep line fishing and you're doing just tuna, you may not need to go over 3,000 because we're at 1,621 right now. Even if we were to double that amount, we'd just be filling the boat up all the way. Maybe the second storage, so you go to 4,000, and that would always cover you for this. But if you're going now, once again, when I go spearfishing, I fill the boat up all the way to 6,000, 5,000 something, and I make a lot of money. So I almost feel like spearfishing is still the better way to do it on this little boat. Now, if you get bigger boats, obviously the bigger they are, the more money you're going to haul in. So keep that in mind. Tell you what, though, guys, I love the fact that you can click the clock now. That is a huge... What? What do you mean no fish were caught? It had a bite mark on it. Frick. Okay, well, screwed over on that one. That was a glitch. So let's go back and let's see who... Look at our finances and see who is selling. Let's see. We want to go looking for swordfish. 625. 40 bucks in Lunenburg. 43 at Lockport. 6 bucks at Ingalls. 11 in Digby. 37 at Dennis Point. So, Lockport it is. So let's go ahead back. Let's go ahead and fast travel to Lockport and we'll call it a video. See how much we make. So if I'm honest with you, I really am I still make more money doing the spearfishing, I think. But let's see. We'll see how much we sold. Oh, I forgot to put Micah back in his... Whoops. Okay. We would like to sell... Yeah, his whoops. Yeah, man, what a dud. 70,000 bucks. I mean, that's still a good amount of money, but I made way more money harpooning than I did doing that. So, I don't know. But this is easier than harpooning because you know exactly where the fish are, so it's kind of a trade-off. Like, what do you think is going to be the best for you? Because obviously, the deep line fishing is faster, easier. You just jump to that spot, drop the lines, sit there for 2 minutes, you know, advance the clock, pick up the fish, and then come back in and sell them. But if you're trying to get, you know, if you want to get out there and get into the adventure and make $200,000-$300,000, you're better off to putter around and look for the fish on the surface, even the tuna. And if you bring them to a port where they're selling well, you're going to get a good price. So you're going to make a lot of money. So like you saw when I first came into this video, I made, what, $180,000, $170,000. Turn around and do this, and I make nothing. So, well, 70,000 bucks. It's nothing to sneeze at. In fact, I think that puts us in range of several of the boats that we could buy, you know. So we're just going to keep fishing with this boat for now, though, and I will catch you when I'm ready to buy my next boat. The snar set is what I'm aiming at. I want to get $1 million together, and I want to buy the snar set and fully outfit it and fully crew it, and then go out and do some line fishing with that. So, or even net fishing, we'll see. But the nice thing about the net fishing is you don't have to worry about bait. So, but if your crew is bad, they'll damage the nets, and I'm kind of bad at doing the nets too. I always screw those little puzzles up. So, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video as we went out and made some big bucks. But not quite as big as I wanted to make. Like I said, the harpoon fishing is just much better income, but it is more work. So, I don't know. It's a trade-off. Have a great night. Be sure to subscribe, thumbs up, voice help, and I will see you next time. Bye.